Hello everyone. So today we are going to learn about oxygen therapy. Now in this presentation, we'll be learning about differences between the terms hypoxia and hypoxemia. We'll be learning about goals of oxygen therapy. Then we'll be having an understanding when to give the oxygen therapy and the precautions for oxygen therapy. So understand the terms hypoxia and hypoxemia first. So hypoxia is a state of the body in which the oxygen supply is insufficient for normal life functions. The most common causes for hypoxia are, you can abbreviate them as HID, which is hypoxemia, ischemia and dysoxia. So hypoxemia is one of the causes for hypoxia. Hypoxia is a state where oxygen supply is insufficient, whereas hypoxemia is a condition or a state of the body in which there is low arterial oxygen, that is called as PaO2, partial pressure of arterial oxygen. So the causes are HID, hypoxemia, ischemia and dysoxia. Hypoxemia due to low arterial oxygen content, ischemia due to reduced cardiac output, and dysoxia due to problems in oxygen uptake or poor utilization of the oxygen, that is abnormal tissue oxygenation or abnormal tissue oxygen metabolism by the cells. Now, goals of oxygen therapy. What are the goals of oxygen therapy? So there are three important goals. That is to correct the oxygen levels. Correct the oxygen levels in both the arterial blood and also the alveolar oxygen levels. So correct the oxygen levels in the arterial blood and alveoli to reduce the symptoms of hypoxemia. The next is to reduce the workload of the heart. To decrease the symptoms, we'll be reviewing the symptoms of hypoxemia in the next slides. And the third goal is to reduce the workload of the heart. Now what happens basically is, if at all there's increase in the load on the heart, if at all the hypoxemia is present, then the heart tries to compensate with increase in the heart rate, or it can increase the force of contraction of the heart. So when you give oxygen, the amount of oxygen in the blood will increase, and thereby it will help to reduce the workload on the heart. So heart won't have to pump excessively in order to supply or in order to maintain the oxygen in the body. So when to give the oxygen therapy? So oxygen therapy requirement can be based upon three things, which is lab results, the condition and the symptoms. As we had seen in the previous slide, to reduce the symptoms. In this slide, we are going to see the symptoms as well. So when to give the oxygen therapy? Based upon the lab results, based upon the condition, and based upon the symptoms. Based upon lab results, the lab results of PaO2, lab results of SpO2, and lab results of SaO2. Now, there is actually a small difference between SpO2 and SaO2. Both give the same thing, that is the saturation of oxygen in the blood, or the amount of hemoglobin which is saturated with oxygen, but only the way in which both are measured is slightly different. SpO2 is measured with the help of a pulse oximeter, and SaO2 is measured invasively it's the actual saturation of oxygenated hemoglobin in the arterial blood. So only difference is the way it is measured. SpO2 is measured by pulse oximeter and SaO2 is measured invasively. So oxygen therapy can be based upon these lab results, which we'll be discussing shortly. The next is a condition. Condition can be abbreviated as CAMPT, which is COPD, corpulmonale, in post-anesthesia recovery, myocardial infarction, poisoning of carbon monoxide or cyanide, or trauma. And symptoms, again, those are divided into respiratory, cardiac, and neurological. So respiratory symptoms are tachypnea and dyspnea. Cardiac symptoms are tachycardia, hypertension, and neurological symptoms are confused state, delirium and disorientation. So based upon these three things, lab results, condition, and symptoms, we can give the or we can initiate the oxygen therapy. Now we'll just discuss in short about the lab results. Saturation, as we discussed before, SpO2 and SaO2, only difference is the way it is measured. It gives the saturation of the hemoglobin which is oxygenated. Then there is ABG results of PaO2. Now the indication or when to start, the indication are slightly different for newborns and the adults and children and infants more than 1 month old. So if at all the PaO2 of a newborn who is less than 1 month old is 50 mmHg, we can start the oxygen. For adults, children and infants more than 1 year, 1 month old, when the PaO2 level is less than 60 mmHg, we can initiate oxygen therapy. Now saturation, SaO2 or SpO2, if for newborns, if it is less than 88%, we can initiate oxygen therapy. For adults, children and infants more than 1 month old, if at all the SaO2 or SpO2 is less than 90%, we can initiate the oxygen therapy. Conditions in short: COPD corpulmonale, anesthesia, post-anesthesia recovery or post-surgical, post-operative procedure, we can initiate oxygen therapy. In case of myocardial infarction, especially in the case of acute myocardial infarction, poisoning, carbon monoxide poisoning, cyanide poisoning, etc. and after trauma. So in these conditions, we can initiate the oxygen therapy. Precautions to be taken. Precautions, very important. Chronic hypercapnia. We have to take precautions while initiating the oxygen in case of chronic hypercapnia, which is specially present in the case of COPD. Now, why this happens is because of the increase in the CO2 levels in the blood. The CO2 level act as the initiator for the respiration. So the hypercapnia is actually, it initiates, if at all the CO2 levels rise in the blood, it signals the brain that the breath has to be initiated. So it acts as a initiator for respiration or inspiration. So if at all the hypercapnia is suppressed with the help of oxygen therapy, what will happen is the breathing or the ventilatory drive of the patients with COPD will be reduced. So that's why we have to take precaution in the case of chronic hypercapnia. The next is, in premature infants, you have to make sure that the PO2, you have to take care, especially in the case of premature infants, that there might be retinopathy of prematurity. So if at all PO2 is more than 80 mmHg, there are chances of retinopathy.